Senator Morrison. Following that, we'll have the roll call by, of the Senate by the Secretary. Senator Morrison.
Will everyone please stand up and bow their heads? Thank you, Lord, for giving us the opportunity to meet together this evening so that we can conduct this meeting. We hope that everything said and done in this meeting will help our schools become better. And we also hope that you allow us to make it back home safely and all of our help.
Amen.
Armand Duncan.
Present.
Bianca Brewington.
Present.
Brent Batiste.
Present.
Charles Stewart. Jasmine Williams.
Here.
Joy Henderson.
Here.
Keltrin Burrell.
Present.
Kiana Daniels.
Here.
Kiana Edison.
Present.
Me. Lawrence Williams. Leah Kite.
Present.
Nathan Morrison.
Present.
Nathaniel Hampton.
Present.
Thank you, Senator Lastman. Now, if everyone would take a glance at the agenda in front of you. It's been brought to my attention that there are two controversial amendments that senators would like to consider tonight. Is there a motion on the floor to add consideration for these agenda, these constitutional amendments to the agenda?
I move.
Accepting a motion from Senator Lashley and a second from Senator Batiste. All in favor of making that amendment to the agenda, please say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay. Are there any other amendments to the agenda? Are there any other amendments to the agenda? Are there any other amendments to the agenda?
Yes.
Yes,
I need to add.
Okay.
I need to add.
Senator Lassie, what would you like to add?
Okay, a judicial report by the Chief Justice, Mr. President.
Okay.
And also a constitutional amendment.
following item five of the agenda, the executive report. Insert B for the judicial report. Okay. At this time, if we could have President Nicholas Hayes or a representative from his cabinet to present his executive report.
Good evening. My name is Trinicia Holt. I am standing in the place of Nikon tonight. The president report reads as follows. As of this date, these are the projects and activities on the agenda for the Student Government Association Executive Cabinet for the close of the semester. Repainting of campus bookstore, installation of a student lounge area in the lobby of Dunn Hall, installation of new washing machines / student ID swipe payment systems in the residential housing units, installation of bike racks for the students in collaboration with student affairs, and a campus-wide opinion box and campus maps. Upcoming events and tentative dates, 1,000 canned food drive in collaboration with Southern University Laboratory School, Scotlandville, Mankin High School, and student government throughout the remaining months of November and December. Bayou Classic Pep Rally, F.G. Clark Activity Center, scheduled for Monday, November 24, 2014, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Bayou Classic Bonfire and Seatbelt Safety Display, SU Pavilion, Monday as well, November 24th, 9 p.m. to 12 a.m. Pack the bus for early voting that will be held on Tuesday, November 25th, 2014, from 11 a.m. to 5 p.m. The Presidential Roundtable, Sip and Chat, Tuesday, November 25th, 2014, from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Everyone is encouraged to come out. He stated that, I wish everyone the best of luck on the remainder of your class sessions and finals. I also wish you all to have a safe and happy holiday and encourage everyone to support our Jaguars on their journey to the SWAC championship. Thank you.
Thank you. Do you guys have any questions for Ms. Holt about the president's report? Okay. Okay, thank you, Ms. Holt.
No problem. All
right, and now we'll have a judicial report from our Chief Justice.
Good evening, Minister Hope, Chief Justice, and just reported as past business, we were able to get amendment passed to change the rules on quorum. Present business, we got two bills up for whatever. Ratification and future business. Try to set up some study sessions to learn the Constitution for election tests for the springs. And other future stuff is to review more Constitution, more of the Constitution, and provide more amendments to make it clear and more easily accessible to understand. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Hall. Okay, and now we'll have appointment approvals for officials to elected positions. I know that Mr. Edmund Johnson is here to take the oath of office. If you'll please come forward. Are there any other appointment approvals candidates here tonight? Yes, ma'am. All right, Mr. Johnson, if you can introduce yourself then. If you can introduce yourself, I'll give you your name, your major, and what your interest is in the position that you're vying for.
My name is Edmund Johnson. My major is criminal justice. My interest is to help the campus and the student body to thrive with the initiative the Senate is trying to pass.
Okay.
My major is nursing, and my initiative is to help the student government in order to provide a bridge between the students in the office.
Okay. And what position are you on? Thank you and welcome to the Senate. Mr. Johnson, we've got confirmation that you have met all the requirements for elected office. And thank you for your legislative assistant position. If you come and join the rest of the legislative assistants up here, is there any other legislative assistants who just walked in or who are sitting in the audience, if you'll come and join us this way? Mr. Johnson, at this time, Mr. Marcus Coleman is going to come and give the oath of office to you. And following that, we're going to have some legislation updates on some of the initiatives from each committee.
Solemnly swear,
solemnly swear
that I will faithfully execute,
that I will faithfully execute
the office of the Student Government Association,
the office of the Student Government Association,
in your position,
senior class senator,
and will to the best of my ability,
and will to the best of my ability
preserve,
protect,
and defend,
the Constitution,
of the Student Government Association, of Southern University and A&M College. Congratulations.
Okay, good evening everyone. I'm Senator Lasty.
I'm Senator Hampton.
And we have campus beautification. So on the Sunday, I think that was two Sundays ago, we assisted with painting the home. Senator Hampton and I, and Senator Henderson was also there. And I contacted Mr. Cordell Beal, who's over Building and Grounds. I'm still waiting on a response from him to go ahead and paint the Jaguars in front of John B. Cade Library and in front of the school, and to plant some flowers around there. So, thank you.
If you guys could take photos as well. Okay, we spoke earlier about landscaping plans, and you guys have talked to Mr. Bill?
Yes, I'm waiting for him to respond back to me. I'll talk to him
on the how'd you contact him?
Via phone.
Did you set a meeting with him?
I haven't seen him. That was on Monday.
Okay. Okay, I'll talk to you guys later
about how to get in contact with a little bit. Okay. All right, campus safety. Good evening, everyone. I'm Senator
Baptiste. And I'm Senator Edison.
Well, we are currently working on a proposal to housing for the SWIP system. I have contacted several companies that say that's administrative meeting, but none of them have responded back, but Custom Security. And I actually sent a picture of our ID to them, and they still haven't gotten back. We're trying to set up a meeting again, but it's a work in progress. And we have to talk about the character for the end of the matter, too.
So currently I'm working on getting a GPS system for the CATS buses so that we'll all be able to know where the buses are at a certain time. I've contacted our computer science program whose chairman is Dr. Kazarabi. My issue is that they just had audits, I think they called it audits, last week, so they haven't been able to fit me in. I was supposed to have a meeting on Monday, but it didn't go. It didn't work out. I mean, no one called me to cancel or anything, but I will definitely try and get in contact with this, with Dr. Kazarabi again, probably tomorrow.
Okay. And with the campus life, I'm supposed to be picking up a report every Thursday from the chief of police. Does the police give us their evaluation on lighting 3 times a week, which is Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. But last Thursday, I went to pick one up, and it wasn't ready, and I forgot to go back Friday. So, and I plan on seeing the difference in the reports and actually bringing it to Mr. Guillory himself. Me and the fellow Senator Edison to meet him.
Okay. So what are you guys doing
Good evening, everyone. My name is Armand Duncan, and myself and Senator Williams are over at Campus Dining. Currently, we have 3 items that are listed, which includes extending cafeteria hours, offering work study for students after hours, and opening a late night snack shop. Now, the status of that, we're really just looking forward to following up with Aramark. They're pretty much already aware of the initiative that we have in mind, so it's just a matter of sitting down with Vice President Martin, once again, to kind of go over everything in detail one last time before we kind of move forward with it, but that's pretty much where we stand with that.
Okay. Do you guys have any questions? Okay. I look forward to seeing what you guys do. The child care committee. And then following that, we'll have the Finance Committee and Public Relations after that.
Hello, everyone. My name is Bianca Lawrence. I'm working with Charles Stewart, a fellow senator of the freshman class, on child care. We spoke and we brainstormed some ideas, and I went to Pinky Thrift where the old daycare is near. Over, but no one could ever speak to me about it. So I guess I'm going to try to talk to someone to move it off campus, because I've been in that building before and it's actually like really small. Sarah brought it to my attention that if everyone had a child, you know, it wouldn't be a big space. So I'm working on talking to someone about it.
And overall, the project that you're aiming for? Overall, the project that you're aiming for is?
Getting a bigger facility.
In general, as far as child care goes? To let the audience know what you're trying to accomplish.
Somewhere for the students who have children and the teachers, well, the administrators here who have kids who take them to daycare off campus, we're going to make it cheaper and an easier pay plan, and then they will pay at a regular daycare for the children.
Okay. Thank you very much. Does anyone have any questions for some of you? No? Okay, thank you. Finance Committee?
To develop a better way to get the organizations the money, right? So that's what we're going to be working on. I got to get with Sarah for that. We haven't started anything yet, but we have asked for the balances of all the student fees so that we can see what the surplus of money is, and maybe we can actually get an initiative accomplished with the surplus of money that we have left over in previous years or this year.
Good evening. I am Senator Joy Henderson. Senator Kelchin Burrell.
We're planning of.
Okay, yesterday we met. We plan to do the website. We have the outline already set up. We just need to put it in place. And the future of references, we plan to do another Jaguars. Ready once the spring semester starts, because we have new people coming in. We want to get our numbers up so we can get more people involved and know everything about campus events.
And with the website, we're planning to get, it's going to be an SGA website only. So we're planning to get information from each branch so we can put on the website, because each branch is going to have their own session. And we're planning to get it published by the spring semester, before the spring semester starts.
Okay. Anyone have any questions for the public relations team? Okay, thank you. Recycling and sustainability.
Good evening, my name is Nathan Morrison.
Hello, I'm Senator Lee Knight.
And also working with us is DeAndre Brown. The purpose of our initiative is to get more students thinking about sustainability and how it affects them on their daily lives. Right now, we're trying to place recycling bins throughout the campus. We have drafted a proposal to be sent to all the college deans who do not already have these waste bins. DeAndre went and talked to Ms. Vicky, who is the CFO secretary, to see about what funds we have, if any, already available. He found that she basically gave him a runaround and told him to go talk to Dr. Davis. We're still trying to set up a meeting with the CFO. We're also researching recycling waste regulations to see if we can use the waste bins that we already had, or do we need to purchase any more. We're also trying to create a committee that will be responsible for making sure that when this initiative is established, that it will be sustainable.
Senator Kite, anything to add?
Perfect. He did a good job.
Any questions from the senator? All right, thank you very much. And finally, a special event.
That all the senators and legislative assistants, if you're available, be there by 2:30 so you can help with setting up for the event, registering the veterans upon their arrival, passing out programs, and etc. We also ask that you wear white top and black bottoms just so we can all look uniform and they can recognize us easily, because we won't have people serving the food and we'll be doing that, so it's just kind of easier if we all wear the same thing. After the completion of the meeting, we'll kind of break down where everybody wants to help out at the luncheon. And then also, we're still trying to do the Thanksgiving Day baskets. I'm gonna pass out a list via GroupMe and via our Gmail emails of like a concise list of what we plan on putting in Thanksgiving Day baskets. It's not a lot, but it's enough to say that it will help with a person who is in need of a meal for Thanksgiving. And we are also still working on the Senate Night Out, which hopefully we can collab with the SGA and they can do the first one coming back in January of 2018.
Also, this wasn't in my drafted plan, but I just thought it was a good idea. As far as the Thanksgiving drive, if you don't want to like buy an item or anything to donate, you can, I had an idea to donate $11.26 because Thanksgiving is November 26th. Or is it the 26th? Whatever. You know, you get the. So if you don't want to donate items, just donate. And as far as the Veterans Day luncheon, I have spoken to Southern's ROTC. Although they can't be available for the luncheon, they offered to write a statement, you know, commending the veterans and honoring them, and we will read it on their behalf. So I need to assign a senator or a legislative assistant to read that love for them. And
okay, do you guys have any questions for them right now? So, thank you very much. All right, and entertaining the other addition that we made for the agenda, item B under section 8, the constitutional amendment. The senators responsible for sponsoring this bills may take the floor.
Constitutional amendment. An amendment calling for the formal change to the vacant procedures of the Office of Chief of Justice. Section 1, Student Government and Constitutional Authority. It believes that we, the students, have the right and, I mean, as well as the responsibility to play a significant role in guiding our university and in our belief, mutual belief, that democratic student government is the best means by which all this role of Southern University Agricultural and Mechanical College at Baton Rouge, Louisiana, thereby create the Student Government Association. Deriving its authority from the regular enrolled student body and its existence being recognized by the faculty and administration of the university, the Student Government Association has and continued to implement programs for improvement and enrichment of the university community, as well as expressing opinions of the students on any and all matters that are concerns of the general welfare of the population.
Section 2, Statement of Purpose. The purpose of this amendment is to strengthen the Student Government Association Constitution Judicial Branch in such a way as to provide more effective and adequate changes to accommodate new situations that the Student Government Association currently faces. Section 3, Constitutional Amendments. The Student Government Association Constitution, Article 6, Section 4, currently written. If a vacancy occurs in the judicial branch, the president of the respective class in which the vacancy occurs will have the right to nominate a sufficient replacement, one who has fulfilled all requirements for holding office within one calendar week. The replacement must be confirmed by a simple majority vote of the Senate in order to serve and will serve until the next regularly scheduled campus-wide election. As amended, if a vacancy occurs in the judicial branch, the president of the respective class in which the vacancy occurs shall nominate a sufficient replacement, one who has fulfilled all requirements for holding office within one calendar week. The replacement must be confirmed by 2/3 majority vote of the Student Senate in order to serve and will serve into the next regularly scheduled campus-wide election. If no sufficient replacement is nominated within one calendar week of the vacancy, or if the sufficient replacement fails to obtain a simple majority vote of the Senate, the Chief Justice shall assume responsibility and have authority to nominate a sufficient replacement until the vacancy has been filled. Student Government Association Constitution, Article 6, Section 8, currently written. In the event that the office of the Chief Justice becomes vacant during a term, the Student Government Association President shall have the authority to appoint a replacement who has met all of the qualifications for serving in office. Such a replacement is subject to confirmation by 2/3 majority vote of the Senate. as amended. In the event that the office of the Chief Justice becomes vacant during a term, the Student Government Association President shall appoint a replacement who has met all the qualifications for serving in office. Such a replacement is subject to confirmation by 2/3 majority vote of the Student Senate. If no appointment is made within one calendar week of the vacancy, or if the appointment fails to obtain 2/3 majority vote of the Student Senate, a special general election shall be immediately held to fill this vacancy. Section 4, enactment of constitutional amendments. This amendment shall be enacted and incorporated into law immediately upon the majority vote of the Student Government Association Senate of Southern University and Agricultural and Mechanical College, present and voting, and upon the added signature of the Student Government Association President, or upon the lapse of time allotted for presidential action, or immediately upon the overriding vote of the President's veto by the Student Government Association Senate, and upon the approval of the administration of Southern University. Upon the final passage of this amendment, all words or phrases within the Student Government Association Constitution, bylaws, and any other Student Government Association document shall be revised to reflect all changes and or conflicts within these documents. A copy of this amendment shall be transmitted to the Vice Chancellor of Student Affairs, Dean of Students, Director of Student Programs, President, Vice President, Chief Justice, Men's Federation President, AWS President, and the respective undergraduate class presidents at Southern University and Agricultural Mechanical College of Baton Rouge only upon the final passage of this amendment. Doesn't have an exact mitt, because they need 9 acting justices in order to fully practice. So in the case that there is a vacancy, they're saying that the Chief Justice would have permission to select a member, so that way they can fully act.
Instead of the President, the Chief Justice will select the member to become.
Maybe you guys want to read the as amended section again and go from there.
If a vacancy occurs in the judicial branch, the president of the respective class in which the vacancy occurs shall nominate a sufficient replacement, one who has fulfilled all the requirements of holding office within one calendar week. The replacement must be confirmed by 2/3 of the Senate majority vote of the Student Senate in order to serve and will serve until the next regular campus-wide election.
So what does it mean? This is what they're saying.
It's saying that.
So that he would select someone and he would vote to approve their appointment.
Yeah.
Okay.
Until like the function election or something like that.
Right.
That's
so
he appoints them in the spring.
For Chief Justice.
Or Chief Justice.
Or not Chief Justice. I'm sorry. For a justice position. I apologize.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Are there any other questions? Now I have a question.
Why
would the Chief Justice be in charge of enforcing a law? Is that not an overstatement?
Not enforcing the law, actually appointing somebody to a position that he has vacant in his branch of government. I feel like he should have that power.
But opposed to anything that you feel, his authority is only to interpret the law and not to enforce it. It would be a president's job to appoint someone in my legal position.
Okay. But have all the positions been filled by appointments? They haven't?
What do you mean?
The current positions, have all of them been filled?
If they weren't elected? You'd have to check with the Chief Justice.
Chief Justice, you have a full justice. Yeah. Judiciary branch, I'm sorry. Do you have one?
Yeah.
No, Chief Justice.
It's, yes, but as of right now, yeah, it will get.
Okay. three-branch government system has a legislature that creates the law, a judiciary that interprets the law, and an executive branch that enforces the law. Do you believe that the Chief Justice should appoint someone to the judiciary, which is also a conflict of interest, if he is not the enforcer of the law?
I believe he should have a conflict. Because he's over that branch of government. Those people work under the same.
The only people allowed to consider talk about the bill are citizens.
What's the conflict of interest?
That the person over the same branch of government would decide who would be in that government, which conflicts the people's choice to who should represent them.
But technically, it wouldn't be.
But
it's
saying,
it's only like a last resort.
Yeah. A last resort if there's no sufficient place to nominate. So would that be okay if at the last resort they need someone to do the appointing or someone to do the choosing, because clearly the president of the respective class did nominate a sufficient place. Yeah. Was that?
That's up to you guys.
It's only saying that if it's. If it's a vacancy, say if, like in the spring, there's 8 justice positions open per each class. There's 2 per each class, so a total of 8, including the chief justice, that's a total of 9. It's stating that if, say, 5 justices don't take the test and there's 5 vacancies, if there's a vacancy, it's just saying that he would have the ability to appoint someone to that position.
But wouldn't that be just like, okay, like, if we have vacancy on our Senate,
the president a 1 calendar week to actually appoint
him. So they're giving the president a chance.
Yes, right. To do it. But if the president fails,
it's a last resort. So that way they can have a full judiciary.
If it's a net, and you guys know that the trend is that the president usually doesn't appoint someone in the calendar week, how likely is it that that rule will end up being the chief justice appointing people to the judiciary?
I think that would be just
it would be very the chief justice to make it.
And again, how is it the chief justice? How is it under the chief justice's control to choose who will represent the
city? Well, if the president is not doing, he's supposed to get somebody to do it.
That's very true. If there are vacancies due to someone not taking the test, and the president is unable, the respective class president is unable to locate or find someone to appoint himself, it's saying that the chief justice then can step in. It's not saying that to eliminate them taking the test or to eliminate the president choosing. It's saying if those two options are not met properly, then there's something that the chief justice can do, so that way he can have a full and active judiciary.
It's giving them a time frame to pick an appointment.
When they make that decision, does the president still get the interview though that he appointed? So say if I appoint someone and I'm a president, and another president wants to meet that person, do they still get the interview that person?
Well, I mean, the president doesn't, they only interview their cabinet. They wouldn't interview it.
They're supposed to interview their cabinet too.
So is that,
so how many
can that be added?
Do we have any justices in the audience?
Maybe in calendar week, just in the 1 calendar week, 2.
How many justices have been interviewed by the president?
Excuse me, fellow senators. I move that we table this amendment after further consideration of all the stipulations that apply to it, so I move that we table it to
I second.
Accepting a motion from Senator Daniels and a second from Senator Williams. All in favor of tabling this amendment, please say aye.
Aye.
Are there any opposed? Thank you.
Enjoy the group. Okay.
And now for the next constitutional amendment.
The money.
Y'all didn't want to do it? Oh, you don't want to do it? Okay. Okay. All right. So, just to the audience. Thank you guys for coming out tonight. We would like to announce again that we have a Veterans Day luncheon. So if you all have any family members, campus alumni, anyone that you know that is a veteran, we are honoring them on Sunday, November 23rd at 3:00 p.m. in the Royal Pacific Ballroom at Smith Brown Memorial Union. Is it you know them on campus? Talent show tonight starts in 10 minutes. Okay, and then now we'll have the benediction by Senator Hampton.
Would you all please bow your heads? Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for a successful meeting tonight. We pray that everybody gets home safely, and we pray that we all come up to again another time to have another meeting and get work accomplished. Amen.
This meeting is now adjourned.